All right, welcome everyone. I'm just about to do my first Scars of Mirrodin draft online. Pretty excited that it's finally here. Been doing a bit too many M11 drafts for my own good. All right, so let's get into it. For a first pack, there's a few cards. I think Tumble Magnet is a decent pick. The Battle Gear doesn't seem too strong. Galvanizer could be a pick. I think the safest choice is the Revoke Existence, mainly because it's a removal spell. White's a good color to get into if you're able to, and it doesn't really pick any strategy in white. Like, there's white creature decks from what I've seen, and there's, you know, Metalcraft and stuff like that, and this ignores all of that, so it's a pretty safe pick. Tumble Magnet will be a little bit safer, but not on the same power level. So we're gonna grab the white card. All right. So what we have here that I think are strong, I'm still new, is like Darksteel Sentinel seems good. Not good. This early, there's a Trigon of Rage. Glimmer Point Stag, and then a couple of the infect spells that are really good. I think I'm going to stay with white, especially because 3/3s for 4 are pretty good in this format, and this guy gets some work done. So, staying with the white cards. So I've only done a handful so far, and I found that there's some really interesting draft strategies, and one that I haven't tried yet that I'm really curious, and this pack is exactly what I wanted to see, is how the Sunspear actually does. He seems really, really powerful, and something you could draft around, but like in this pack there's a great blue creature and a red removal spell, so it's a tough decision. Like, obviously the removal spell is more powerful, and it, you know, it can deal with the equipment and can do a couple of good 2-for-1s. But I think I'm going to try taking the Sunspear and see how that works. I just want that for practice with Grand Prix Toronto coming up. Alright, that is a very late skin render that is, you know, it's going to be the pick. There's nothing else. It's better than every card I have so far. There's still a couple white cards coming around. You know, I have no clue what to think of Clone Shell, but I did see Luis playing it at the last GP, so it's probably unplayable. Yeah, so just skin render, and I don't think anything's coming back. Okay, there's another Turn to Slag, which is really good, and there's another Sunspear. Even though we don't have any equipment yet, I still think I'm going to take this guy and see what I can do with him. We're going to be forced to, like, highly evaluate equipment. Like, this is even something that we'll probably want to play, but this card's really good, and we kind of want to try to get into white-black now, just for the power level of some of the cards that we have. So I'm going to take the 3/3 for 3 flyer. Actually have not drafted yet in this format and not had an artifact yet, so that's pretty interesting actually. But we have some really good creatures, and we might not have any synergy with them, but I don't think that's needed when, you know, well, I guess we have synergy with these two guys. That'll be really fun. Okay. So here there's not really many playables that we're going to want to grab. Like, this isn't going to be a signal, so we don't have to worry about taking it. The Acid Web Spiders, I think, is pretty good. Everything else is pretty mediocre. We can take this and maybe potentially have a splash of red for maybe a bolt or something. I forgot the name. I don't know the name of it yet. The Artifact Bolt. So I think I'm going to just take that, send the signal for someone to be in green. I really want these colors to come back. Alright, I think the replica is the pick. Like, we want to get an artifact or an equipment here sometime soon, but Like, I potentially the 3-mana equipment might come back, and that's a little bit better than this one. And this is a pretty good card, so I'm going to take the replica. A lot of greens coming around the table. Okay, well, the might have been the next pick. I haven't, with it being a new format, I guess I've slipped on knowing when cards come around. I think it was in this pack, though. So, we can take a combat trick. I guess the combat trick doesn't even seem that bad in our deck. We're kind of just efficient dudes, so I wouldn't ever think of playing this before, but I could see it being a main deck card in this deck. Alright, we have Tainted Strike, and then we have the Life Staff. So I think I'm going to take the Life Staff just in case we don't get any equipment later on. Alright. I'll keep passing the Infect spells. I think our deck's going to be pretty good against Infect. And I can see this being played, especially if we're pretty aggressive. Still, the wall, I don't think we'll ever be able to get around it. This card, like, Vigil for the Lost seems really, like, the ability is really powerful for a life gain spell. Like, there's, you know, many times you want to play a life gain spell, but I could see boarding it in against specific, like, you know, obviously not poison, but some aggressive deck, I could really see bringing it in just for the potential of just being devastating. Every creature gets you, you know, 8 life or something. Alright, even though I think there'll be creatures that are under 12, I don't want to take that. I think this card's fine in a deck with a ton of mirrors or something like that. It's definitely a powerful ability. But, so this pack is nothing really exciting for us. I guess the Glinthawk Idol is the most aggressive card in the pack, so, and it's the best one for our color, so I guess we're just going to force that. I don't really know how good that card is yet. That's the card we're looking for, Darksteel Axe. It is miles ahead of everything in this pack. Let's see how many cards are in here. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, we won't get the Spell Bomb or even the Skyguard probably back. I think too many white cards and nothing really else to be played, so can't expect anything to come back. Alright, so the most impressive card in this pack is actually the Perilous Mirror. If you haven't played this format much, this guy is very annoying early. He gets in, he blocks, he kills a lot of efficient guys. Like, he's all around just annoying and a really good card to have. Most of the annoying cards usually don't, you know, lose their effects after a couple turns, but not that guy. He sticks around. So I don't know what to think of Soul Perry yet. We can take, you know, Copper Mirror, but I don't think this deck is the kind of deck that we're going to want a ton of mirrors in. We don't have any Metalcraft, we don't have any big spells. We just have a lot of efficiently costed creatures. I think this is where I'm going to take the Darksteel Sentinel. Gives us, like, this late game push guy, and it's a trick, so that's pretty sweet. Okay, I guess we're playing a 3-2 for 3. I don't see anything else that I'd really want. Don't think this card's that good. Especially not with our deck. We don't have any, like, card advantage to create card advantage. And I see our creatures either living or trading all day long. This is actually interesting. We could take a 3-2. Or we can take a 2-4. I think those are the picks that we have here. Like, even though we might not get Metalcraft, I still think that the Warden's a little bit powerful, and who knows how many more artifacts we get in the deck. I don't definitely want to have to pick artifacts just for the fact that I have this guy, but I think he's slightly better than the Reaver.